Welcome back, lawn lovers. BW here again. Hey, can you believe it? It's time to start snow mold prevention already. It's October 23rd today, and it's time to begin snow mold prevention and prepare the lawn for another long winter. Gray and speckled snow mold begin to grow in October when soil temperatures cool down to about 50 degrees. If you're a lawn lover and live in a cold climate like I do, it's time for us to get moving. Today I'm applying my first round of fungicide. Fungicides can get expensive, so I'm only applying it to my small front and side lawns that I give extra care to all season long. Unfortunately, all the work you do to improve your lawn makes it a bigger target for snow mold. Snow mold loves beautiful lush turf. I decided to use Anderson's Prophecy for this application. Propiconazole is the only active ingredient, and it's a good fungicide for all three types of snow mold. It's been found to be most effective when it's used in the first application. Some fungicides are not allowed for use on home lawns, so be sure to read and follow all the directions on the label of any fungicide you decide to use. Fungicides for snow mold control in home lawns include the active ingredients azoxystrobin, propiconazole, pyroclastrobin, and tebuconazole. But watch out, they can be paired with fungicides that are not allowed for home lawns. Just read the label. It'll tell you if the product is safe for use on your home lawn. Propiconazole and azoxystrobin are readily available in garden store products like BioAdvanced and ZZX. Liquid fungicides can be used, but you can only use them in calm weather conditions. I prefer spreading granular over spraying liquids. The weather is the most determining factor in whether you will get snow mold or not, and there's nothing we can do about that. The worst case scenario is a lasting heavy snowfall that happens before the grass has had a chance to harden off and before the soil has had a chance to freeze. That happens quite often in the northern tier of the United States. When lush green grass is covered under a relatively warm blanket of snow, it gives the snow mold fungus all the food and warmth it needs to do its damage. There are some cultural methods you can practice to prevent snow mold, including avoiding heavy applications of fertilizer in late fall, mowing right up until the grass completely stops growing, keeping thatch to a minimum, preventing large snow drifts and compaction of the snow cover, and growing varieties of grass that are resistant to snow mold. I do as many of those things as I can, but living in this part of the country, I still get snow mold. That's where fungicide can be useful. Most years fungicide works very well, but it's not unusual to get some breakthrough. There are three types of snow mold: pink, gray, and speckled. Pink snow mold doesn't even need snow cover to cause damage. Gray snow mold needs about 60 days of continuous snow cover to cause damage. And speckled snow mold requires about 90 days of continuous snow cover to cause damage. I have experienced all three types of snow mold in my lawn, but gray and speckled are by far the most common. The truth is that pink and speckled are very destructive. They will damage the grass plant right down to the crown and kill the grass. I know, so why do so many people always say, "Oh, don't worry about it. Snow mold only causes temporary damage." That's because most people don't live in a climate that produces 90 days of continuous snow cover like I do. But if you do, you know how destructive it can be. You may remember what my front lawn looked like just a couple of years ago. I had treated it with fungicide, but I only used one application just before snowfall. Most university research and manufacturers of fungicide suggest that two fungicide applications and two or more fungicides be used in combination or sequentially for areas that experience long periods of snow cover. The second application should be made just before lasting snowfall, so we need to figure out when we usually get lasting snowfall and make our first application a month prior to that. Since it's October 23rd today, I'll be making my second fungicide application in about a month, right around Thanksgiving weekend. There's more you need to know about snow mold, so don't miss my next video. I'll be applying my second round of fungicide. Don't forget to like this video, then hit the subscribe button and ring the bell next to it so you don't miss the next video. And remember, you can do it.